It's Eli Troyer, the president and founder of AgriDry. You can find them on the internet at agridrylc.com. We are less than a month away from the 8th Annual Oilseed and Grain Trade Summit taking place in Minneapolis this year. And join us live by phone to tell us more is Mark Dineen, president of Soyatech. Good morning, Mark.
Good morning. How are you?
Very good. Mark, tell us about this year's bigger and better event with an updated name.
Yes. We changed the name this year. We found that we were more specific to soy in the past, but our audience had been expanding, multiple oil seeds, multiple commodities, grains included. So the name was kind of becoming a little bit of a hindrance, so we expanded the name a little bit, Oilseed and Grain Trade instead of Soy and Grain Trade, so not that much of a difference. And this year we are looking at a bigger exhibit floor, probably upwards of 100 sponsors and exhibiting companies on the show floor. And we're looking at having somewhere between 800 and 900 attendees, both people within the industry as well as importers, buyers coming from around the world.
I know this event brings commodity buyers and sellers together for on-the-spot business transactions. Tell us about some of the key buyers that will be there.
We have people coming from multiple different locations. We've been lucky enough this year. We have probably upwards of 15 to 20 folks coming from China, major importers coming from China, not only looking at soy and some corn this year, but also looking at wheat. So we have some top buyers coming from the standard importers from around the world, but also more locally, we have people coming from food ingredients companies, restaurant chains, major food manufacturing companies. As a matter of fact, we just had a company that just signed up out of California. It's called Marukame, if I said that properly. But basically, they manufacture the miso soup, and they do a lot of soy purchasing for the soup. So we're seeing a lot of expansion away from what was traditional basic importers to multiple levels of buyers.
I know there are hundreds of sponsors and exhibitors there, everybody from ADM to Cargill, the CME Group. You've got CME Group's CEO as your keynote speaker. Tell us about the special course that will be offered by the International F.C. Stone.
Right. Actually, I'm going to back up a little bit. The keynote speaker this year is the CEO of CHS, Carl Casale. So he's he'll be on the 22nd, speaking on the 22nd. And then, we're working with International F.C. Stone. They're doing a special program on risk management. We're seeing a lot of different business activities as well as banking activities that are becoming very important to the attendees at the event. So F.C. Stone is running their own, what we would call a short course on Monday the 21st that would lead right into the opening reception, speaking of risk management issues.
It's hard to keep fresh content over 8 years. You're doing something right to be going this long. But tell us about the new thing as far as tracking the trends that you've got going.
Yeah, every year changes, obviously. One of the things we're doing this year is looking at different sourcing locations, and we're trying to bring new information to the people that attend our event every year. So we're tracking information related to this year, specifically China, Brazil, Canada, and obviously the United States, expanding our sourcing services, if you will, and expanding the opportunity for information. But, you know, every year there's something new going on. Every year things change. Even as things stay the same, things change, you know, depending on weather and budgets and so forth. So it's always good to bring as much information as possible.
Where can folks go to get more information?
Exactly. They can come to the event. It's in Minneapolis, Minnesota, October 21st to the 23rd. Opens up on a Monday, closes on a Wednesday afternoon. Plenty of receptions, plenty of exhibitors, and plenty of business to be had at the event.
Mark, thank you for your time. Hope you have a great turnout for your event in Minneapolis this year.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Have a great day. Mark Dineen, president of Soyatech.